Good day, YouTubers. Hope everyone is keeping safe. In front of me is an ASUS X551M, which was brought to me with a running screen. I know it has a dead battery because to power it on, you must have the power jack plugged in. This morning I will be opening it to see what is what. I'm not sure of what I will find, but usually when using a laptop and you have it on a bed or a rough surface that's not a surface that's not flat, it would accumulate dust and it would overheat. So I'm hoping it's an overheating issue I'm dealing with. I'm not sure what it would be. So let's go on the journey together. This laptop doesn't have an external battery. Everything is internal. It carries 9 screws, which I have already taken out to speed up this process. To open this, after you've taken out the 9 screws, you get a flat object, you put it in the seam, and you could hear the clicking. And you go all around the laptop to try to free it up. Now that it's freed up, if you could not see the opening here, you would flip the laptop over and open it. The other thing is it's still attached at the back. Okay, it's free. The other thing is, do not pull on this cover because it has the whole top plate, the keyboard and the mouse pad is one thing. So you would lift gently. If you notice, you have a ribbon here. That's the keyboard. That's the mouse. That's the keyboard. This one here is the power button. You get a flat object, plastic, and try to get out. The ribbon. you'd turn over and you'd get all the power. Now that these things are out, you would simply lift. Put this aside. This is the motherboard, and you can see the condition. Of it filled with dust. This is the speakers. This is the battery here. Next thing, the battery doesn't have screws. Next thing you've got to do is get the battery out. Do not work. Got it. Now this side here is where it's connected. This is it. This is the battery pack. It's a A3 1N1319 11.25 volts. You put this aside and you look at the condition of this unit. I guess I will have some cleaning to do. So the next thing you have to do, this is the hard drive. You'll remove the hard drive. It has a 500 gigabyte hard drive. Then you place your finger on your push it back. Place the hard drive on the side. Next thing you would do is take out the Wi-Fi connectors. Just remember the where the wires were. It looks like this screw has. Okay, I'll leave this for last. Then you would unscrew the motherboard. Okay, then you would take out all the cables. Yep, that is out. That is out. That's the cable for the Okay, it seems like I didn't have to take out the Wi-Fi cable. All right, look at the state of the board. And look at the condition with the dust of the CPU fan. It looks like it's held in with one screw. Okay. Look at the state of the fan. So I will take this outside and dust it out. So I'll stop the video here. This is the CPU fan. I've cleaned it, cleaned the motherboard, now I would be removing the CPU. It don't matter how you take it out. What matters is when you putting it back in. It has numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. You have to tighten the screws in that manner. The piece is all dried up. And the numbers on this would correspond with the numbers down here. Just remember to match it the same way. I got some rubbing alcohol. Make sure you get everything out and it's shining. Once you put on your thermal piece, then you place the CPU plate back. I never thought this video would have been so long.
You won't tighten all the way, but you'll do it in sessions. Thank you. Now that is out. You take the piece and start reassembling things. Start putting things back in place. No.
I'll stop the video and put in all the screws because this video would be long. I've placed all the screws. Now place in the hard drive. Put in the screws back for the hard drive. Replacing the battery. For me to power it, I would have to connect the power button. So I'll pause the video and I'll hook up these three ribbons. I've placed the ribbons. Let me power on the unit. The monitor is still doing the same thing. But when I hook it up, the fan is not turning now. So that means I have a bad screen, bad battery, and a bad fan. The CPU fan is also bad. This is it for this video. The repair wasn't successful, but I think you all learn something with this ASUS X551M laptop. I will put the screws and the cover back off camera. The video got a bit too long already. Hope you like this. Until we meet again, please like, comment, subscribe, click on the bell icon so you'll be notified of further videos. Goodbye.